Good morning, I'm Mark McAllister. The prime suspect in the JonBenet Ramsey murder case is back in the United States this morning, but questions are still being raised about last week's confession by John Carr.
And good morning, I'm Anne-Marie Medowick. Three opposition MPs are speaking out against Ottawa's stand on the Middle East crisis after seeing destruction in southern Lebanon firsthand.
Good morning, I'm Anthony Robart in Scarborough. Police responding to a number of break-and-enters that they say are as a result of last night's major power outage.
And good morning, I'm Susan Hay. What a beautiful start to your Monday morning. It doesn't all look this way for the remainder of the work week. I'll have full weather details coming up.
I'm Pooja Hanna. We have some problems on the West 401, problems on the Gardiner, as well as in-town delays. All the details are coming up.
And I'm Scott Peterson. Auto workers awaiting a major news announcement this morning that Oshawa will be the site of the new Camaro muscle car. We'll tell you what it means for Ontario jobs coming up in business.
That is not a worm on Scott Peterson's shoulder. It may be back to school season, but it's already beginning to look a lot like Christmas at Harrods department store in London. Today is Monday, August 21st, and this is the morning news.
Does he dress himself in the morning?
We're all having a good chuckle, unfortunately, at Scott's expense.
Mark's crying, actually.
I can hear the director say, fix that.
He's brushing his hair,
let's just start anew.
You look good, Scott.
The
Kleenex,
he'll clean himself up before the next business report. Also ahead this hour, an update on the inspiring story of one youngster trying to help another. Brandon Shupp will join us live in studio to update us on his amazing efforts to raise money for kids with cancer. Poker seems to be all the rage these days, whether it's TV or online, but there's one version of poker that's creating a bit of a stir in cyberspace. We'll find out what that's about in our Strange But True segment. And what's new at the Toronto Zoo this week? We're going to go for a ride on the Zoo-mobile, which is an excellent way to see a great number of the animals and save a few steps at the same time.
All right, but first, several acts of looting are